polynomials. Let us move on to few questions based on the topics that we have covered so far. So here is exercise 2.1 NCERT. The question is, which of the following expressions are polynomials in one variable and which are not? State the reason for your answer. So we are supposed to identify which of the following expressions over here are polynomials in one variable and which are not. And we have to give reason for that as well. So let us see the first question. That is 4x square minus 3x plus 7. So we are supposed to identify whether this is a polynomial in one variable or not. Now we already know what is a polynomial in one variable. One variable means only one alphabet should be used. So is there only one alphabet used? Yes. Which is that alphabet? That alphabet is x. And can we call this expression as a polynomial? According to the definition of the polynomial, this expression will be a polynomial only if the power of the variable is a whole number. So the power of x in this case is 2. The power of x over here is 1. And the power of x over here, as we know, it is 0. So we know that this entire expression can be called as a polynomial because 2, 1 and 0 are all whole numbers. Therefore, yes, it is a polynomial in one variable. So here is the way to write down the solution. So it is a polynomial in one variable x. Now let us move on to the second question. That is 3 root t plus t root 2. So 3 root t. Now which is the variable used over here? The variable used over here is t. So there is only one variable, that is t. But is this a polynomial? That also we are supposed to identify. If you observe properly, this is root t. Root t. That is square root of t. Now how do we write down square root of t as? We can write down the square root of t as t to the power half. We can write down root t as t to the power half. Because it is square root. Therefore we write down t to the power 1 by 2. If it was like this, you have studied this in the previous classes as well. If it was something like this, that is cube root of t, we would have written this as t raised to 1 by 3. If it was fourth root of t, we would have written this as t raised to 1 by 4. So here clearly we know that it is written square root. So square root of t can be written as t raised to 1 by 2. So we can say that the power of this t over here is half. So the power of t is half. Now, is this half a whole number? No, half is not a whole number. Why? Because we know all the whole numbers starts from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. 1 by 2 is a fraction. Therefore, this expression will not be a polynomial. It is in one variable, but it is not a polynomial. This can be called as an algebraic expression in one variable. But we cannot call it as a polynomial in one variable. Therefore, here is the solution. So, no. The exponent of the variable t is half, which is not a whole number. Therefore, this expression is not a polynomial. So, remember this term, that is exponent. All the terms are same. Exponent itself means index. And index itself means power. So, power, index, exponent, they are one and the same. Let us move on to the third question. Y plus 2 upon y. Now you may feel it is a polynomial in one variable. Again, one variable is used, that is y. That is absolutely fine. But we have to check the power of y. The power of y here is 1. The power of y here is also 1. 1 is a whole number, therefore it is a polynomial. But no, when we write down y plus 2 upon y. Now this y is absolutely fine. The power of y here is 1. But when this y will come in the numerator, that is, when this y will come somewhere over here, then we write this down as y plus this y is raised up. It was 1 over here in the denominator. So when it will come up, it will become y raised to minus 1. Now, is this minus 1 a whole number? No, minus 1 is not a whole number. Therefore, this entire expression will not be considered as a polynomial. Again, it is an algebraic expression in one variable, but it is not a polynomial because the power of y is minus 1 and minus 1 is not a whole number. So we write it down like this. No, the exponent of the variable y in the term 2 upon y is minus 1. As we have clearly seen, this y, when it goes to the numerator, it becomes minus 1, which is not a whole number. Therefore, it is not a polynomial. Let us move on to the next question. Write the coefficient of x square in each of the following. So we are supposed to write down the coefficient. So recall what a coefficient is. Coefficient means the numeric value along the variable. So here are few questions. Let us concentrate on the first question. That is 2 plus x square plus x. We are supposed to write down the coefficient of x square. That is the number attached with x square. So if I have 2 plus x square plus x. Now their question is, what is the number attached with this x square? As you can see, there is no number written over here. It is assumed to be 1. It is assumed to be 1. That means the number over here is 1. So this 1 is nothing but the coefficient of x square. So 1 is the coefficient of x square. So the answer to this question is 1. Similarly, if they would have asked you what is the coefficient of x, again there is no number over here. So coefficient of x would also be 1. So we write down coefficient of x square is 1. Similarly, in the next question, slightly same as the previous question, minor changes, 2 minus x square plus x cube. So 2 minus x square plus x cube. So this is the question, second question, and we are again supposed to write down the coefficient of x square over here. Again, can you see any number over here? No, that means the number over there is 1. So let me write down 1 over here. But in this case, if we observe properly, the coefficient of x square cannot be taken as 1. We have to take it along with its sign. So we will take it as minus 1. So the coefficient of x square in that case is minus 1. In the first example, it was plus. Therefore, we had written just 1 over here. Now, again, we placed a 1 over here, but along with the sign, it will become minus 1. So we write down the coefficient of x square is minus 1. And in the last example, you can clearly see the number attached with x square. Now, which is the number attached with x square? So you can clearly see this entire pi by 2. This entire pi by 2 lies alongside x square. Therefore, pi by 2 is the coefficient of x square. Write the degree of each of the following polynomials. So here are a few examples for you. Let me concentrate on the first example. Here is the first example. The power of x here is 3. Then the power of x is 2. And then the power of x is 1. As we can write down 1 over here. Therefore, which is the highest power? The highest power is 3. Therefore, we say that the degree of this first polynomial is 3. So this is the polynomial in variable x. And the highest power is 3. Therefore, the degree of this polynomial is 3. Similarly, if we move on to the second question, you can easily identify what will be the highest power of y. The highest power of y is 2, right? Therefore, we can say that this is a polynomial in variable y and the highest power of the variable y is 2. You can see over here. Therefore, the degree of this polynomial is 2. The next question, which is the variable used? The variable is t. The variable is t. What is the power of t over here? The power of t is obviously 1. Therefore, we can say it has, the degree has to be 1. Therefore, the degree is 1 in this case. So we say this is a polynomial in variable t and the highest power of variable t is 1. Therefore, the degree of this polynomial is 1. In the last example, recall what type of polynomial it is. It is a constant polynomial. And we also know that degree of the constant polynomial is 0. How? Because if I'm having 3 over here, I can place an alphabet. Say for example, A. And then I can write down raised to the power 0. I can write it down in many ways. I can again write down this 3 number. I can write down this 3. Then I can use variable as x also. And again, I can write down raised to 0. Therefore, I can say in the last example, since it is a constant polynomial, there is no variable attached over here. Therefore, its degree is 0. So this is a constant polynomial. Degree of a constant polynomial is always 0. Let us move to next. Now we are supposed to classify the following as linear, quadratic and cubic polynomials. So linear means the degree has to be 1. Quadratic means degree has to be 2. And cubic means the degree should be 3. So let it be as it is so that it will be easy for you to identify. So here are a few questions for you. So let us see the solution one by one. In the first example, you have to just identify which is the highest degree. The highest degree is 2, that is the highest power is 2. Therefore, the first example is an example of quadratic polynomial. So the first example is an example of quadratic polynomial. So we write down like this. So x square plus x is a quadratic polynomial as the degree of the variable x is 2. Again, in the second example, very easy to identify. Again, the highest power of y square is 2. Therefore, again, it is a quadratic polynomial. So y plus y square plus 4 is a quadratic polynomial as the degree of the variable is 2. If we move on further, this is a simple one, 3t. What is the power of t? The power of t is 1. So which kind of polynomial it is? It is a linear polynomial, we can say. It's a linear polynomial because the degree is 1. So we write down 3t is a linear polynomial as the degree of the variable is 1. In the last example, you can clearly see the power of x over there. The power of x is 3. So it is a cubic polynomial. So here it is, 7x cube is a cubic polynomial as the degree of the variable is 3.